Today we're going to be talking about diffusion barriers and pre-plates. Step 3 in the electroplating process is the application of a final plate, a diffusion barrier, a pre-plate for the purpose of brightening, or a pre-plate for the purpose of repairing. If your item is ready for a final plate in step 3, then after the application of that plate, your electroplating process is complete. For some projects, step 3 in the plating process consists of a diffusion barrier. If you're unsure if your item needs a diffusion barrier, consider the following information. All gold plating is somewhat porous on a microscopic level, and this porosity can allow reactive metals such as copper, copper alloys such as brass or bronze, non-stainless steels, and silver to corrode under the gold plating. As the base metal corrodes, the base metal oxidizes and can seep or diffuse through the gold plate and appear on the surface as an unsightly tarnish. This diffusion tarnish can make the gold look dull or dark or seem to wear off sooner than it should, leaving your customers feeling that they didn't get the quality they expected. By plating your gold thick enough to effectively seal the base metal or by adding a less reactive diffusion barrier under the gold, you can avoid this issue. Because of the cost of increasing gold thickness, along with the uncertainty of how thick the gold plating layer actually is, the addition of a diffusion barrier is usually a recommended remedy. So to review, some of the reasons why you may want to add a diffusion barrier to your plating process is if the base metals are prone to corroding or oxidizing and diffusing up through the gold, or the base metal is capable of dissolving gold. This usually occurs with tin. In this situation, a diffusion barrier is required given that plating the gold layer thick enough will not resolve the issue. There may be other reasons why you might want to use a diffusion barrier, but these are the most common ones we see with our customers. Increasing the gold thickness instead of a diffusion barrier can be kind of tricky. Ensuring that you have a sufficient gold thickness to prevent diffusion involves several considerations. These include types of gold plating applied, base metal reactivity, the corrosive nature of the environment, environmental temperature, environmental pressure, environmental humidity, and how long you expect to avoid diffusion. It is also important to consider the type of diffusion barrier used. For example, nickel is a common diffusion barrier. However, nickel is often not used for jewelry items since it can cause an allergic reaction in many people. In this case, we would recommend rhodium or palladium. Palladium is an excellent diffusion barrier because it will not corrode, although it is more expensive. A nickel diffusion barrier can also be problematic if it is exposed to sea air or any environment where the item may be exposed to salt, salt water, or salt mist. This is a photo of a gold-plated item where the nickel is diffusing through the gold plating due to exposure to salt spray. The green crystals are nickel salt crystals, and they have diffused through the gold plating. Nickel often works well as a diffusion barrier, but not in every application, as you can see. We are often asked how thick the gold should typically be to avoid a diffusion barrier, but as explained previously, this is a difficult question to answer without more information. However, generally speaking, an item exposed to average room type conditions should have at least 1 to 2 microns, or 40 to 80 microinches, of hard gold to reasonably ensure that the diffusion isn't a problem over an extended period of time. If your item is in need of brightening before the application of a final plate, step 3 of your plating process might include a pre-plate of bright nickel or palladium. Gold plating reflects the same luster, brightness, and finish of the metal that it is being plated onto. If that surface is dark or dull, the gold plate will be as well. For example, if you gold plate 2 different coins, one that is shiny and one that is dull, after the gold plating, you will have 2 different outcomes that reflect the original finish. For surfaces that need brightening beyond what can be accomplished with polishing, the addition of brightening pre-plate can be helpful. Bright nickel is an easy way to brighten up the surface and have an even finish all over. Palladium is a durable and nickel-free option. It is brighter than nickel, but it also is more expensive. And it doesn't have the ability to level and fill in scratches like nickel can. If there are scratches, flaws, pitting, or texturing on your piece that you'd like to fill in and repair before the application of a final plate, step 3 in your plating process might include a pre-plate of either bright nickel, or bright acid copper. The following details can help you determine what solution to use for your project. Bright nickel is the best for minor scratches, equivalent to about 800 grit sandpaper or finer. It can fill in those scratches and smooth them out. To achieve a good finish with bright nickel, you shouldn't have to plate more than 15 minutes. We recommend removing your item from the solution periodically to check and make sure that the scratches are filling in. If there are any errors that occur in the plating process, bright nickel is very difficult to polish down and smooth out. Bright acid copper is a soft metal that is buildable and it also is easy to polish down. It is ideal for providing structure to delicate and thin items, especially non-conductive items that have been coated in conductive paint. If your item has scratches or flaws that are deeper than what you would see from 800 grit sandpaper, or if it has a texture or pitted surface, then bright acid copper is the best choice to fill in and smooth out those flaws. We recommend using bright acid copper to fill in the flaws until they are at least comparable to 800 grit, and then finish plating with bright nickel. Plating for about 5 minutes with bright acid copper should be sufficient to fill in scratches. To cover up texturing or pitting, you will need to plate for about 15 to 20 minutes. In some situations, it will be necessary to periodically remove the item from the solution and sand it down to level out the surface, and then repeat that process until you've achieved the look that you are wanting. It is important to keep in mind the tolerance of items that you are plating. Applying either bright acid copper or bright nickel can build metallic thickness and change the dimensions of your piece. This is particularly crucial for guns and machined parts. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to learn more information on diffusion barriers and pre-plates, you can contact us via phone or our tech email. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.